Welcome to four examples of determining basic limits. We first have the limit as x approaches negative 2 of 4. So notice for this example, we're using the constant function f of x equals 4 to determine this limit. So let's begin by looking at the graph of this constant function. It's a horizontal line passing through y equals 4. And here's where x equals negative 2. And notice, as we approach negative 2 from the positive side or right side, and as we approach negative 2 from the left side or negative side, not only is the function value approaching 4, it's always 4 because we have the constant function. And therefore, this limit is equal to 4. But this does bring up an important point when determining limits. The limit as x approaches c of f of x equals f of c, meaning we can determine this limit by performing direct substitution with x equals c if f of x is continuous over an open interval from a to b that contains c. Which means we should become familiar with the types of limits that can be determined using direct substitution by knowing where functions are continuous and not continuous. And if a function is continuous over all real numbers, we can always determine the limit by performing direct substitution. So looking at our second example, we have the limit as x approaches 3 of x, which means, again, our function is f of x equals x, graphed here, which would be the identity function. But because this is a line which is always continuous over all real numbers, we can simply perform direct substitution to determine this limit. So if we substitute 3 for x, notice how the limit is just equal to 3. To understand what's happening graphically, here's where x equals 3. As we approach x equals 3 from the right side or positive side, and as we approach positive 3 from the left side or negative side, in both cases, we are approaching the function value of positive 3. Next, we have the limit as x approaches 4 of negative 2x plus 3. Once again, notice the function is a line where we have f of x equals negative 2x plus 3, which again is continuous over all real numbers, and therefore we can determine this limit by performing direct substitution, which would just be negative 2 times 4 plus 3, which would be negative 8 plus 3, or negative 5. So the limit as x approaches 4 of negative 2x plus 3 equals negative 5. Or analyzing the graph, here's where x equals 4. Notice as we approach positive 4 from the right side or positive side, and as we approach positive 4 from the left side or negative side, notice from both directions, we're approaching the function value negative 5. And for our last example, we have the limit as x approaches 0 of 0.5x cubed plus x squared. Notice how our function is a polynomial function, which once again is continuous over all real numbers, and therefore we can find this limit by performing direct substitution. We substitute 0 for x, we would have 0.5 times 0 cubed plus 0 squared, which would just be 0 plus 0, or 0. Looking at the graph, here's where x equals 0. As we approach x equals 0 from the positive side or right side, and as we approach 0 from the left side or negative side, notice how from both directions we are approaching the function value f of x or y equals 0. I hope you found these four examples helpful.